Good morning, good life, everyone. Welcome back to Amy TV, where we come together to help you go after the life that you want. I have not always been an early riser. As a matter of fact, I'm not even an early riser every single day. Snooze used to be my very best friend. And then I found out what real friends were. Over the last 10 years of my life, I have changed a lot of things, and one of those things is the time that I get out of bed. Waking up at 5 a.m. is not for everyone. A lot of people find it to be completely insane, and there was a time when I believed it as well. So that's what I want to talk about today, just a little bit of insight from somebody who used to feel that way. Why would you even bother waking up at 5 a.m.? Why I wake up that early? You know how the first thing you do when you get to work in the morning is to make sure you've got your coffee? If it's not coffee for you, it's some drink, but you make sure you've got it before you can start your first task. Let's say you're reporting to work at 9 a.m. and your typical wake-up time is 7:30. Well, you've really been rushing through the day to get to where you are now, and all you need is that cup of goodness. So you roll on into the cafeteria to get your first cup, and you run into Betsy from accounting. Ugh. You know Betsy. She's the early riser who has lots of energy every day, and when she sees you in the morning, she's got questions and stories, and you haven't had your coffee yet. Not today, Betsy. Not today. It's a buzzkill before your buzz. Yes, there was a time where I was judging these people and I just didn't understand. How do you wake up so early and still have energy 4 hours later to talk to me right now? But with life comes experience, and I have since learned Betsy's secrets. It's kind of hard to ignore them once you know them. You can't unknow them. What is it about early risers that sets them apart from the rest of the crowd? What is so great about waking up at 5 a.m.? Well, there's a study out of the University of Westminster that says that people who wake up between 5:30 and 7:30 in the morning have higher levels of the stress hormone cortisol. Now, cortisol is great in a situation when you need to be alert. I personally am always wondering where my cortisol levels are. That's something I literally think about. This is extremely helpful and is great in the morning, but is also heavily reliant on getting an ample amount of sleep for your body to function. So you can't just wake up early and have great cortisol levels and lots of energy. It all works together. So you're gonna need that sleep in order to make it all worthwhile. So again, why do it? Before I can tell you why, you know what time it is. I've got to give a little bit of Twitter gratitude, and today that goes out to Mike Alton. Mike, thank you so much for your time and attention on these videos. You've supported me for so long. I appreciate it. I acknowledge you. And thanks a lot for the retweet. If you would potentially like a shout out here on Amy TV, all you got to do is follow me on Twitter, retweet my latest video when it comes out, and I might just pick you. All right, now let's get into what is so darn sexy about waking up at 5 a.m. because it's not the alarm clock, which I still need. In a bad way. First of all, this is an introvert's dream. If you wake up at 5 and it's something that a lot of people don't like to do, then a lot of people are still sleeping and a lot of people aren't bothering you. No one talking to me when I wake up in the morning. It is awesome. I get so much quiet time to myself that helps fuel me in the moments where I have to deal with talking to other people, whether I'm going to meetings, taking phone calls, talking to employees, whatever the case may be. Pretty much any human interaction is something that I needed to save up for in my introvert bank. Okay. Another big reason that I wake up early is that working from home is a very scary place sometimes, where you can work any time of day because your desk, your computer, the internet, all the things are just ready whenever. And that can be very unhealthy with life balance. So being able to make specific times of day where I am getting work done and then still allowing myself like a clock out time as much as I possibly can so that I can still have family time and personal time is really important. And the more I get done at my most productive hour in my home office where no one is bothering me and normal home distractions aren't taking me away from it, the more likely I am to be productive that day, even if for some reason my workday gets cut short. The more hours that I am not distracted in the morning to get things done are more productive hours overall. That was one of the biggest things when I started working from home, and I have done a video on this as well. It's so easy to just work all day and all night because you can. And when you're passionate about something, you do. But waking up early in the morning helps me find the balance I need later in the day when my body and my mind are not tip top and ready to do my greatest work. The third reason I think I wake up early is that I am a feelings person. I want to not only be productive and check all the boxes and feel very efficient and look at my nice little calendar blocks, whatever, but all of that has to do with whether or not I feel productive as well as actually being productive. One of the things that makes me feel that way is waking up early. I do tend to get hard on myself if it's a weekday and I got plenty of sleep, but things just didn't go right and I slept in a little bit more or missed my alarm and I missed an appointment with myself. And first thing in the morning from 5 o'clock to like 9 o'clock, those are all mostly appointments just for me to get things done. And I feel just as bad not making good on an appointment for myself as I would for anyone else, whether it's a phone call or a coffee. The appointments with myself are real things getting done, and those are the biggest missed opportunities. So it's not just actually getting things done. I wanna feel productive, and I feel that way when I'm up earlier. I think the fourth reason that I like to wake up early is I'm not somebody who relies a lot on light. I'm relying a lot on light right now, I'm not gonna lie. I mean in the sense that I don't have to wake up with the sun to feel, I don't know what it is. I think there's people who really look to the sun as a feeling that they need to get up or something that energizes them to get up. For me, it could be raining, snowing, I could be somewhere where it is dark 20 hours a day. That would not affect me as much. I don't feel that the dark is dictating whether or not I'm awake or not. I think that's really important to identify. You know, if you have the ability to control your schedule in a lot of ways and you have recognized that you need sunlight in order to feel like you can function, maybe waking up at 5 a.m. isn't for you. I'm not sitting here saying that it is for everyone, but you need to figure out what early looks like or what staying away from people and your cell phone and the internet looks like in the morning so you can get the most out of that time. And I think the final reason that I do wake up early is because I'm very good at getting sleep. I'm very regimented. I love going to bed and making sure I get at least 7 hours. Lately, it's only been about 6.5, which I'm kind of bummed out about. Like, I'm like, I need to be at 7 hours. But even at 6.5, I feel pretty good and I'm not undersleeping and I feel like I'm performing at the highest level as I can first thing in the morning, and then it starts to taper off around 3-4 o'clock in the afternoon, and that's working for me. If you're someone that struggles with a sleep disorder or insomnia or something like that, that's not something I have experience in, and that's gonna completely really mess you up. And I know that there is medication for that for some reason. I don't necessarily think you should do anything other than what's right for you and what you've talked to your doctor about. That's a big component of whether or not any of this other stuff will work. And I know somebody who struggles to sleep is thinking, yeah, messes with my day, okay? But I do feel very fortunate that at this stage of my life, I'm sleeping very well. Apparently my stress is on the up and up on that end. And so that allows me to be able to wake up early and be effective, not feel like I'm just drudging my way through the first couple of hours in the morning. First couple of minutes, yes, we are drudging. So that's why I wake up at 5 a.m. If you want more details on how to wake up at 5 a.m., I have a video on that. Go and check that out. The link is in the description and I'll throw it up here in a card as well. Let's share what we learned today in a little tweetable. Lose an hour in the morning and you will be all day hunting for it. Richard Wadley. All right, I want to hear from you. What time do you wake up and why? Share that in the comments below. That's all for today. Thank you so much for tuning in. I appreciate it. As always, make sure you subscribe for good vibes, kiss the ones you love, and go after the life you want. Cheers. Why is everybody from accounting when we're making jokes? I think it sounds funny. I think that's why.